Hello friends, today we discuss about another palette of LabVIEW. Like in functions we have programming, then we have boolean palette. We just look it and I will discuss about every part of it. So first we have AND. In this we have, in earlier classes we discussed about like AND gate, OR gate, XOR gate, NOT gate. So we can create any functions using this. So in this case I just create a control over here. This is a X push button and this is Y, and over here this is my indicator. So as I know, when I hit on continuous, so as I know in AND gate, if 00 is there, the output is 0. If 10 is there, in this case the output is 0. If 01 is there, the output is again 0. This is the truth table of AND gate, and when both the input are 1, means X and Y are 1, and in this case we got the output. So this is the AND gate. So I just stop this, and when I go to another function OR gate, this one, I know that OR gate truth table. So according to the truth table, these functions will work. So right now I got this OR gate, and also I use XOR gate. I just connect X to X and Y to Y and create a indicator in this case, and again indicator in this case. So this one is my XOR, or you can say exclusive OR. This is OR gate and this is the AND gate. So when I hit on continuous button, as you see in this case, first 00, in this case all are off. When one is on, in that case OR gate truth table is that 00 0 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 1, and exclusive OR says that if one input of these two is high, in that case it will give a value. So when both are on, in that case XOR will off. So this is the truth table the result according to the truth table. So I just go to another function. Over here we have a NOT gate. It directly just negate the value, like X, if X is off or on, like in this case X is on, it will give me off, and when X is off, it is on. Okay, so this is the case of boolean palette. Over here we have NAND gate. This is the NAND gate, this is the NOR gate, and this is the XNOR gate. So these are the different digital gates. Over here, using this we can use these function in our different applications or any program. Over here we have AND array element. Basically over here we have simple buttons, and if one we want to take the result of array, like first I create a boolean array. So I just take a blank array, and in this blank array I just take a boolean function like push button, and in this I have these elements, only 4 elements right now I have, and I want to take the AND of these array element. Okay, so just connect this and create an indicator. So I right now we know that if all the elements of this array are 1, in that case it will on, otherwise it is off. So when I hit on continuous run, right now this one is on, result is off, and when I hit on this, all are 1 and the logic AND gate will on. As you see, this will AND all the array element. Okay, so in this is the case when, in this case we take or of all the element. So create indicator, in this case this is the logical or of all the array element. So first I close all the elements, and when I hit on continuous run all the of, when I hit on any one, like in this case on, this is the truth table of, this will follow the truth table of OR gate. Okay, now we have number to array conversion or array to number conversion or boolean to number conversion. Okay, so first I take this one, number to boolean array. In this case we have a number, like create control, and over here we have a array for that. Okay, so as you see, in this case when I put on 0, it will give me this one, 1. So it is on, this is the LSB, and when I put on over here 8, so as you see, this is my 0 position, 1, it is basically 2 0, 2 raised to 0, it is 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4, 2 raised to 5, 2 raised to 6, 2 raised to 7, 2 raised to 8, and you can increase up to your values. So when I put 16, in this case you got, and when I put on 15, so this is the case, you can convert number to boolean, and also array to number. We have array like this, and over here create a indicator in this case, and when I put this on, and it will give me 4, because 0 0 1 it is equivalent to 4. You can, if you are confused with that, so I just take a horizontal value as you see, and when I put on this on also, it will give me 12. Okay, so another expression is boolean to number. If we have a boolean number and we want to convert this into 0 1, then we can use this function. So like this, so first I delete all this. We have a boolean function like push button, and we want to convert this value into, we want to convert true false into 0 1 for further use. So it is the case when I hit on continuous, right now false is there, so 0 is there, true is there, 1, 0 1, 0 1, 0 1. You can use, basically this function is mostly used in hardware interface. Okay, so next we have, these are the constant, this is the true constant and this is the false constant. You can use this function in your VI. So this is all about boolean palette in LabVIEW. Okay, thank you.